Hey guys, I'm Dr. Ariele Foster, and this is Claire Kelly, Pilates and yoga teacher. We're going to talk today about hypermobility, the elbow, and Purvottanasana. So first thing first, I want to show you guys that there are two different ways of looking at the elbow. First is in the front-to-back plane, which you can see if you turn to the side. So when Claire turns to her side, and she lifts her arm up, so just sit on your heels. And she lifts her arm straight in front of her, the front to back plane, and really, really straightens it. You can see that she's got hyper extension at the elbow. So she has about 15 to 20 degrees of hyperextension at the elbow. And then when she and I both turn towards the front, you can see that we have slightly different what's called carrying angle. This is in the coronal plane, the side-to-side plane. And if I hold the strap up to her upper arm and keep the line straight, she has, again, about 20 degrees of carrying angle. Now, for women, 25 degrees is more typical. So I would say Claire actually has a little slightly less carrying angle than average. But carrying angle, if you have both, it can make a huge difference in your weight bearing through your arms. Asana practice. For me, I have just the tiniest bit more carrying angle than Claire, or maybe about the same. It's hard to tell. I didn't bring my goniometer today. But I have essentially no hyperextension at the elbow. But enough about that. We're going to look at Claire's Purvottanasana. So let's get this out of the way. And Claire, would you go into the pose? So when Claire fully straightens her elbows but feels straight to her, she is in that position of hyperextension at the elbows. And you can see that 20 degrees or so of hyperextension that she has in weight bearing. So right now, I'm not going to keep you there too long. This, by the way, is the angle of her shoulder blade. So it's flush against her back. It's in a slight anterior tilt, appropriate for the pose. Come on down, give yourself a rest. We're gonna go right back up and she's gonna unlock her elbows and we're gonna see what happens to the shoulder blade when she unlocks the elbows. Because a lot of teachers will look at this hyperextension and think that that's a negative thing automatically. But when Claire unlocks her elbows, she goes into massive anterior tilts in the shoulders. This collapses straight out again, so you can see. And it goes from this angle of the shoulder blade, this is the shoulder blade flush against her back, to collapse again. A big difference, like a 30 degree difference here. And that's gonna really shorten up pec major, pec minor at the top. It's gonna really feel uncomfortable and it's not gonna allow her to experience the full pose, essentially. So if you have any questions, you can write them in the comments below and we'll do our best to answer. Thanks. Okay, we have to add one more thing. So I wanted to show Claire from the side in a non-weight-bearing position. So when she turns towards me, and reaches her arm straight behind her, you can see that, just like she was in Purvottanasana, palm down, you can see really clearly that if it, lift your arm as high as you possibly can. Now try to unlock your elbow. You can really see very clearly the anterior tilt that that's causing in the shoulder. So really lock out the elbow, and how much that opens up the front of the shoulder. So it's not always a black or white issue when it comes to hypermobile elbows. Thank you so much, Claire.
Thanks, guys.
Post this online.